Hi, I'm Alexa Edwards. This is A Day in My Life by Sports Stars Magazine.
I'm on a new level. 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 Brought me a new Chevy. Put these in the dirt. Chain with the new vest. On my put it work. I'm on a new level. I'm on a new level.
I'm on a new level.
I'm on a new level.
I'm on a new level.
I'm on a new level.
I'm on a new level.
Brought me a new Chevy.
Brought me a new Chevy.
Put these in the dirt. Chain with the new vest.
Brought me some new vest.
On my put it work.
My mom actually played a volleyball. She played at UOP, which is where I'm going. And I've been in the gym with her since I was first grade. She made me fall in love with it. And so that's where I started.
I think there's a tough balance. You know, the expectations of that everybody has, knowing who I am, and me balancing as a dad to not put any pressure on her. So I followed a couple of rules, which never ever sort of forced her to do anything, practices, play, workout, anything else. And then I have what I call the 1 hour rule, which is we never spoke about the results of a game after an hour. So I wanted to teach her that the key to sports is no matter how good or bad you play, you move on and the sun will come up tomorrow. She's handled all of her success far better than I would have at her age. So I guess that's a good compliment.
In history, we're talking about we're in the civil rights movement, the 1960s, and that's just really inspired me because civil rights is obviously, it's still a big issue in today. So that has really inspired me to speak out more about stuff and just always be open to people speaking to me about their issues and just trying to be the best person I can be. I want to be a police officer after I graduate from UOP. So I'm really hoping to either stay down in Stockton and get into the department, or probably LA, somewhere big where I can help, and then eventually go on to be in the FBI. That'd be really cool. The reason I went to this school is because I knew that if I went here, I would have a really overwhelming sense of sisterhood. And just every single day, it's nice always seeing my friends' faces. I know a lot of people in the school. So I'll just go around and everyone smiles at each other. We're all nice. The teachers are amazing people. The coaches are amazing. And I just have an overwhelming sense of family that when I come here.
So this is Jack. It's kind of a hot spot. We usually go here before games. We go here a lot. I usually get Chipotle before games, but I'm compromising and I'll get Jack's. I'll get a salad. But yeah, I think I'm probably gonna get a steak Caesar salad. You know what? I don't care. Chicken fingers.
There you go.
Everything this season is about my team. It's always been about them. And I'm just really focused on getting them to where they want to be.
It's been really fun to see her grow, not only as a player, but as a leader. It's like having a second coach on the court. Because she'll tell the kids, kind of calm down, what to do, get them pumped up. And then she leads by her example and effort. And she's just a blessing to be able to work with.
Sam, Kathy and I were all on all captains, so we're all on the court, and we would just really try to, through our play, help lead people instead of trying to yell at them or anything. We lead through our play. So me having momentum and trying to play my best, that's just me trying to lead my teammates, and I feel like that's just why we play so hard. We have really good setters on my team, Ellie and Jezeray, so that really allows me to be able to hit. And I do training outside of volleyball at Albie and Connie, so that has allowed me to get my strength up. But honestly, it's just my team. They hyped me up before. Sam, our libero, she always helps me with knowing where to hit and how hard I should hit, if I should tip or go full swing. So it's my teammates that help me the most.